Will AI take or make jobs? The answer is yes, definitely. Historically, we've seen that each technological advance has eliminated some jobs while creating others. In fact, we have more people working more total hours now than at any time in previous history. And that's in spite of automation, which has freed us up from more mundane, repetitive tasks to focus on more creative activities. Also, it's helped to create a higher standard of living overall for everyone. Why wouldn't AI do the same thing? Let's take a look and see what I mean. So let's start with a historical perspective. If we were to look at human history across timelines and look at various eras, well, we started off in an agricultural age. And in that time, we basically put most people in the fields. That's what it took in order for us to be able to feed ourselves. We were very inefficient in the way we did farming, so it took all hands on deck to make it work. Then we came along with mechanized farming, tractors and things like that. Now a farmer could plow a field in a day that would have taken weeks before. So now we didn't need as many people working in the fields, and we could still produce the same output. What did that do for all of those folks who now no longer needed to work in the fields? Well, it took away certain agricultural jobs, but it didn't eliminate all of them because we still like to eat. But what did it do for those who got displaced? Well, they moved on to something else. They didn't just sit there and all of a sudden people became obsolete. In fact, a lot of them moved with the industrial age into factories, and we needed people in order to run the machines. Then we had automation come along, and we didn't need as many people operating the machines, and it freed them up to move into information era jobs, which is what a lot of people like me are in these days. So each one of these has taken away certain jobs while creating the opportunity for other jobs. And now we move into the era of AI. And why wouldn't it do the same thing? If we're smart, we'll be able to leverage this and create more new jobs and a higher overall standard of living. Okay, what kinds of jobs are we going to need in this era of AI? What kinds of things will the humans be doing versus what will the AI be doing? Well, it turns out that we're particularly good at certain kinds of things, and AI is particularly good at other types of things. To give you an example, the areas where we would want to continue to focus would be in the area of the big picture thinking. Things like strategy, things like architecture, things like planning, and things of that sort. So those are the kinds of things that a person would be particularly good, at least for now, that's what humans are particularly good at doing. Now, what is the AI especially good at? Well, it's particularly good at dealing with details, with execution, with making this stuff happen. So I'll give you the big picture, you make it happen. That's one kind of division of way of thinking about what kinds of these jobs might be. What are some others? Well, it turns out I think we're going to see people more in the role of supervisory functions. So we're going to be overseeing what the AI does. We're going to be involved in goal setting and doing objectives and things like that. The AI won't know what it is we want to accomplish. We have to decide what it is we want to accomplish. But if I set the goals and I say, I want a program that does this, that, or the other thing, well, it could be pretty good at doing the actual coding, writing the code. Or if I know I need some information about a certain subject, it could be my research assistant and go off and do all the legwork, read all the documents, give me the summaries, give me the kind of stuff I need. But I still had to decide what it was that I wanted to do the research on in the first place. What is this whole project about, in fact, to begin with? Other things that we could think about. Where's areas that AI is particularly strong? Well, if you think about being able to monitor a system, if I'm thinking about cybersecurity, which is the area I work in, that's an area where we need AI to be able to do monitoring, consume lots of information, and tell us when things are going wrong and when they're not. Maybe even advise us on particular kinds of things. So it could look at what all the different alternatives are and even make recommendations. But here's what I'm going to say is where the humans come in. We need to be the ones doing the deciding. We need to be the ones who are making the ultimate decision as to what actually gets done. In some cases, the decision is trivial and we don't have to, but in others, it would be useful if we did. Another thing where AI is particularly good, and I use this myself a lot, is as a brainstorming partner. If I'm trying to come up with a new idea And I need a few more kind of seeds with that. Like, I know in general what the overall big picture I want to do is. And then I say, give me some ideas about this, that, or the other thing. It'll come up with a bunch of them. And it's pretty good at doing that. It's also pretty good at writing, say, first drafts of things. So we could come up with, if I need to do a document, maybe it writes the first draft. But that's not the final version. It's not the final version in a brainstorm format, and it's not the final version of the document. In fact, in both of those cases, I'm still going to have myself, the human, involved in editing, in polishing, in setting the style, in setting the tone, making those kinds of changes. So I might have it write the first draft, but I'm going to be the editor. I'm going to also be the assignment desk. I'm going to come up with what the things are that need to be done. Use these two together, then it becomes a tool. Then it becomes the force multiplier that we're hoping it can be. So now we've taken a look at what are the things that AI does particularly well and what are the things that people do particularly well. Well, I'll tell you what's even better is if we have AI plus humans, then we end up with augmented intelligence. That's sort of a different version of AI. So it's a force multiplier. We get the two working together. And if we do this right, the whole will be greater than the sum of the parts. In any case, we still need humans in the loop. They're going to have to decide. They're going to be involved in the guiding and deciding aspects of all of this process. So, what skills will they need in order to succeed in the era of AI, these people after all? Well, here are a few that I'd recommend. And the first one I'll start off with is flexibility. You've got to be able to stay light on your feet. Nobody knows what the future looks like when it comes to AI or technology in general. So it's hard to predict exactly where the next twists and turns will be. Stay light on your feet, be ready and prepared for wherever the next direction goes, and run in that direction. Another one is, if you look at, it's really important to be smart, IQ, but what's also going to be more and more important is to rely on something that humans are particularly good at that AI is not, and that's what's called EQ, or the emotional intelligence quotient. So use kind of our own intuition and things like that. Understand and have empathy. That's something machines not particularly good at doing. I actually know some people that aren't all that good at it either, but that's another story. So we need to be able to focus on this EQ aspect. It's one of our superpowers. Let's keep leveraging it. You want to be a lifelong learner. Never get stuck with this. I love learning, and that's why I love working the IT space. And it's why AI looks like yet another cool new thing that we can all learn about. And you should approach it the same way. Look at that not with fear and trembling, but as an opportunity, because that's what it will be for us. And then I think most importantly on this list, it's not one that everyone thinks about right away, and it's critical thinking. It's basically, we're going to need to make these decisions. We can't trust everything that comes out of AI just intuitively. We need to be able to know which things are true and which things aren't. We're going to need to trust, but also verify. And that advice of critical thinking is particularly satisfying, coming from a company whose founder made famous the slogan, "Think," all the way back in 1911. Yeah, that bit of advice certainly aged pretty well. When Edison invented the light bulb, we didn't need as many candle makers anymore. But I think we'd all agree that the light bulb ultimately created far more jobs by enabling us to be less dependent on daylight and improved our overall quality of life. AI can be that next light bulb moment if we do it right.